I need to know how to fix a dishwasher heating element.
I'm assuming the water isn't so hard it has coated the heating element in calcium and lime, so it can't work worth a flip.
If the water was that hard, the dishes would have come out looking like they hadn't been cleaned.
Are you sure you set it to use the heating element to dry the dishes?
I can set it to use cold water and not dry them, but that isn't its current setting.
Be sure the problem is the dishwasher heating element and not some other cause. After all, the heating element usually engages after the wash cycle, but if you open the door too soon to check or empty it, the element won't engage.
We don't check on the dishes the way we do stuff in the oven.
Unplug the dishwasher and then check the heating element's status.
It may or may not be covered.
If it isn't covered, you'll be able to see rather quickly if the circular tube has cracked from thermal stress or broken off because someone dropped a heavy item on it.
And if it is covered, take the cover off and just look for something stressed out other than me.
The heating element has two metal terminals, one at each end. You can check the wiring here to see if that's gotten it disconnected.
This isn't like plugging in a phone or unplugging a can opener, where it might actually be disconnected by a user or improperly connected.
No, but wires can break or get damaged by water exposure.
How do I do that?
When you see the connectors and wires at the base of the heating element, pull only on the connector on the terminal.
If I pull on the wire itself, I may break the connection.
You can disconnect the terminals and take out the heating element before putting the new one in. Remember to reattach the wires and connectors.
Of course, since otherwise the thing won't work.
Or it works until it shorts out and dies.
A fire hazard in a dishwasher sounds like an oxymoron but isn't. If it has a cover, I'd need to replace it too, before testing the dishwasher.
If you don't know if the heating element is bad, you can check it with a multimeter to see if it has proper resistance. However, like oven heating elements, they do go out periodically.
I don't know what reading on a heating element is considered bad, except that it isn't hot.
Turn off the power so you don't shock yourself. Then set the multimeter to ohms, and the reading should be between 0 and infinity.
That's as wide a range as you can get.
If the reading is 0, it is bad, and if the resistance is infinite, it is bad.
How do you get an infinite resistance reading?
That happens when the meter's needle doesn't move at all.
So if it goes to extremes, I need to go to the store and get a new heating element for the dishwasher.
And by having to half disassemble it to test it, you'll be ready to replace it.